Manipur, a tiny sensitive border state, has as many as 17 underground insurgent outfits wanting to divide it up further. In the hills, the tribal Naga and Kuki militants are waging a relentless battle. In the valley, insurgents want a liberated Manipur. The heavy human toll of these clashes plus the valley's communal riots in May prompted the Congressi-led government to call in the army. But is that a lasting solution? Is the problem insurmountable? The Newstrack team visited remote Kuki and Naga villages in the hills to find out. They also travelled on the banned National Highway 39 from Imphal to Moray at great risk to their lives. Mini Ved reports.
Victims of insurgency everywhere speak the same language of pain and suffering. This man's lament could easily be echoed in today's Kashmir or yesterday's Punjab. Behind these images of beauty lie the all-too-familiar images of sorrow. Naga militants set ablaze 22 houses in this Kuki village, Sitta, despite an army post barely 15 minutes away. Today the villagers believe in arming themselves. Manipur's real tragedy is not the fact that it has a history of 40 years of insurgency. It is that no one, not the government, centre, press or public, pays any attention to it. Manipur's five hill districts have, in the last 6 months, seen the most violent phase of the Kuki-Naga feud. What is it all about? The Nagas, represented by the National Socialist Council of Nagaland, want a separate southern Nagaland of their own, which includes substantial areas of Manipur.
We are never Indian, and we will never be Indian, and we have our own right. We have our own right to determine our future.
On the other side, the Kukis, a migratory tribe originally from Burma, have been spurred by their own newly created Kuki militant organizations to throw up a demand for a separate Kuki land. Mention Kuki land to a proud Naga and watch the sparks fly.
Kalla athum hiya naga wingalei hili ralaga naga wingalei li ithum ngayin khui sage pam sage da acha awo yi thodai na tax milaga pamra ka hai ne chui wang aina Kuki na Homeland Manipur hili homeland tanra kichi hiya athumi right male lak mane kala na kawi ngale hi tot ak hena dang dang mami mara kichi hi ithumi na kawi phaisin ne.
For decades, Kukis paid taxes, land tax and a Nagaland tax, to the NSCN. But after the NSCN split in 1988, new Kuki militant outfits were born and the rules were changed. Kukis now refuse to pay taxes. Today, this is the main bone of contention.
Gor nelin athal dala anaga naga hoka ma tax pi tamen de kapi de tilo la gor men ka ma jeng ka hin naga hopi pu ma kati.
This impasse has led to a vicious chain of attack, reprisals, killing, raising of homes and hounding each other out. More than 150 lives have been lost in the last 6 months. Is there any solution in sight?
There has to be a political solution, and it is the government who has to bring that to the table.
Both sides, inflexible in their positions, place the onus of a solution onto the Manipur government, which is clearly in a no-win, or rather, can't do anything to win situation. It can't have separate homelands, and it can't curb insurgency.
I have to admit our deficiency, but deficiency is also partly because we are not determined, we have not political motivation or political determination, but because, you know, the police which is to deal with it is so badly armed and they are so immobile.
It is the same syndrome of short-sightedness that seems to afflict insurgency-ridden states in India, whether it is Punjab, Kashmir or the Northeast. Ignore the problem in the initial stages. In the meantime, militants highlight perceived grievances, gather public support, arms and a mass base, and destabilize the police forces. Political leaders playing off one group against the other lose credibility and finally resort to knee-jerk responses which are usually too little and too late. They call in the Green Berets. In Manipur, the army was called in after 100 deaths and gruesome devastation following communal riots in the valley in May.
Army is not the solution, I know. But the situation as it is, we have to resort to it. We have to depend on them. center should open up a dialogue with these people, with these insurgents, and try to find a political solution.
As in Kashmir and earlier in Punjab, the people's alienation from the national mainstream is very real in Manipur. When the state fails to administer, obviously the insurgents fill the vacuum. In the hills, the Kuki and Naga militants have taken up battle positions. This crucial highway linking Imphal to the border town of Moray has been completely taken over and all traffic banned by the NSCN. Just recently, they ambushed an army convoy, killing 36 people. Newstrack met KNA representatives who crossed over from the Burma border to talk to us. Do they have any clear strategy on how to achieve their goal of a Kuki land in Burma? They seemed quite confused.
The lands which we have occupied just now, it is from the beginning of our forefathers and mothers. So we have to take all, we have to occupy this area, a separate land for the Kuki.
When do you think that you will be able to succeed in this? How long will it take you?
We suppose it will take 4 or 5 years.
You're going to fight with Burma. What is your military strength?
Military train means?
Strength. How many arms, how many people?
So they say about special training trainers, as 600, about 600 volunteers are there.
600 volunteers?
Mm.
And you have sophisticated arms?
Yes. We have sophisticated arms like G3, M16, AK-47.
Do you care about what happens to Kukis in India?
If this tension, all this harassment, all tortures will be going so long, some days we can revenge or we can take necessary action.
With their ongoing economic and traffic blockade of the Imphal-Moray road, the NSCN has openly served notice on the KNA. Who wins the battle for Moray and who emerges the stronger in the Kuki-Naga conflict will definitely not be decided in the near future.